I'll help you with the laundry.
Oh, thanks, Jason.
Hey, don't bother trying to wash my old hockey mask. Those teenage victim bloodstains will never come out.
Oh, don't be crazy, Jay.
Huh?
This'll get them out.
Oh, new Friday the 13th detergent.
Part 7. Just look at these psychoactivated crystals.
Oh, gosh. They're shaped like tiny little chainsaws.
Uh-huh, and they rip the heart right out of dirt and drive a spike through the head of grime.
Oh, boy, can I watch?
Oh, sure. I'll just pour some in and turn it on.
Oh, neat. It whitens as it frightens.
And deodorizes as it terrorizes.
1 hour later.
All done?
You bet. And smells.
Mmm, lemony flesh.
Uh-huh.
When dirt becomes a real nightmare, don't shout it out. Scream it out with new Friday the 13th detergent.
It's the Devil's Music, all October long on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show.
On air, online, anytime, on demand at your fingertips, most major streaming media platforms. We are also on social media, facebook.com/randomositypodcast and X. There it is. Randomosity TOL. People think I'm disorganized. I don't do this on purpose. I just get lost in thought, man. I got so much going through my head at all times. Whoo, buddy. I don't know how I keep it all together. All right, we're here on the program this week. Thanks for joining us. Profiling the month of October, the Devil's Music. And the whole idea being is that these were bands that were considered controversial in the eyes of religious groups, and they were the Devil's Music, and if you listened to them, you were going to go to hell, and, you know, they glorified Satan, and, I mean, I could go down the list. Even though they weren't formed in the 80s, they had been around for quite a while before they really got controversial. Judas Priest formed in Birmingham, 1969, selling well over 50 million albums, consistently ranked as one of the greatest metal bands of all time and one of my favorite bands. Matter of fact, fun story, Judas Priest was my very first concert. That's not even a joke, man. Very first concert, Valentine's Day, 1998. That's it. I mean, they have Judas in the title. How much more controversial can you already be, right? But let's take a look at the controversy itself and how they became that way. In December of 1985, a couple young men had spent a number of hours drinking, smoking marijuana, doing other things, from what I understand, and listening to Judas Priest's classic album, Stained Class. Shortly after this, each man took a shotgun and shot themselves. Belknap died instantly, which is the last name of the one young man, but the other man, James Vance, lived, however, sustaining incredibly serious injuries that left him rather disfigured, and sadly passed away a few years later. Now, before the death of Mr. Vance, the latter young man, he and his parents sued the band and Judas Priest label CBS Records for $6.2 million in damages, claiming that the band had hidden subliminal messages like Try Suicide, Do It, and Let's Be Dead in their cover of Spooky Tooth's Better By You, Better Than Me off of the Stained Class album. And they claim that this influenced both those young men to form a suicide pact. Prosecution played the song forward, backwards, sped it up in an attempt to prove the group had brainwashed these two young men into killing themselves. Okay? Rob Halford, frontman of the band, testified in court that the supposed backward masking in the song was a sound of him exhaling while singing. The attorneys also drew attention to the two young men's troubled childhoods and substance abuse problems. The judge ultimately decided that the group was not responsible for what the two young men had did. Thank God. So looking back on the time period that led up to all of these controversies from the mid-80s, it had built up for them because Priest had done a number of albums that had kind of, I don't say like floundered, but they had like a cult following. And then along came British Steel. This is The Boys from Priest live, May 29th, 1983 at the US Festival. Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show, is what you're listening to. My name is Dr. J. Thomas, and ladies and gentlemen, the doctor is in.
We'll be right back.
His ex-wife called him the devil, so why not play his music all October long? It's Dr. J. Thomas on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show.
Hello, America! This is the biggest collection of heavy metal maniacs in the history of the world! We're gonna go crazy some more for you with this one. You might know it. This is Heading Out to the We got a little something now for you that's We did for you the last tour. It's a little bit of stuff involving the word, the law. You know what I'm talking about, huh? You want to give me the title, Breaking the What?
Breaking the What? Breaking the What?
October long on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show.
All right. Thank you so very much indeed. We have a song that takes us way, way, way back to the Sad Wings of Destiny album. Also Unleashed in the East. You might know this one. This is Victim of Jesus. changes, come on. Give me a long, long changes, come on.
Judas Priest at their peak in the early to mid 80s, and some would say the latter part of the 80s, was so popular that director Rob Reiner went to see them in concert, and it became part of the preparation and inspiration for what you saw on screen in 1984 for This Is Spinal Tap. Huh? Kind of a fun story. That explains a lot.
I turned it up to 11, man.
Good Lord. What a great movie that was. Go see This Is Spinal Tap. That said, Judas Priest is the subject of our show this week on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show, profiling the devil's music. In the month of October on the program, the award-winning Randomosity. We'll be right back, so don't you go anywhere. We're going to have more from Judas Priest live at the US Festival 1983.
It's that time of season. It's that time of year.
If you're from Lima, Ohio, you know what that stands for. And guess what? It is that time right now, as we have done for the last few weeks and will continue to do until the end of the fall semester 2024 here on the program. It's the bonus content exclusively for our streaming media audience, brought to you by Crumbly Comedy. It's the Crumbly Comedy Spotlight. They're putting on shows at Ernest Brew Works downtown, over there on St. Clair. Custom Bent Neon, I believe, is... No, Bent Custom Neon. Jeez. Man, I've got to stop letting people who are on edibles write my notes. It's Bent Custom Neon is another place they're putting on shows. And, of course, there are other places in and throughout. Great Black Swamp is another place. And also down in the Findlay area and in and throughout the surrounding counties, you can find Crumbly Comedy. For more information, facebook.com/Crumbly Comedy. This week, we are profiling a guy that at this guy's peak, there was no one who was more popular, I don't care what anybody says, than this guy in the early to mid-2000s, Dave Attell. You might remember him from the Insomniac show on Comedy Central. Maybe you got to see him on the nightclub circuit. Maybe you were a fan of the Comedy Central Spotlight show that they used to do back in the latter part of the 90s, where for like a 5-minute block, you would see a different comic 4 or 5 times over a period of a half hour. That's where I first became aware of him, was because of those specials they used to run on Comedy Central back in the day. That was when I first saw him. Over time, Dave Attell, though, grew to not only just become a nightclub comic and a TV comic, but he started to play the stadiums when the explosion of people like Dane Cook took place, and you had Greg Giraldo and all those guys that were just setting the cities on fire no matter where they went. Dave Attell was in that mix. Dave Attell was also a favorite of a buddy of mine from back home who is now... I guess big shot down in the TV production world in the Cincinnati area, Jeff Paulus. What's up, bro? Thanks for checking out the program. Dave Attell is the man who's up on deck this week. And this comes from his early 2000s CD that he had through Comedy Central Records. Pretty proud to bring it to you here. This bit right here is track 14 from the CD. So we hope you enjoy it. Check out Crumbly Comedy and what they've got going on, facebook.com/crumbly comedy. And you can find us, facebook.com/randomosity podcast, on Facebook and on X, Randomosity TOL. Here's Dave Attell on the Crumbly Comedy Spotlight.
My midget buddy wants to be a weatherman, but there'll never be a midget weatherman. No one would believe them. A flood is coming. Yeah, to you. What, did someone leave a faucet on or some shit? We call my midget buddy Baby Shoes because he's got tiny little feet. And he calls me Horse Cock Johnson because 4 inches is pretty big to a midget. Me and Baby Shoe, we do everything together except seesaw, because that really wouldn't be fair to him. The other day, me and Baby Shoes, my midget buddy, were hanging around my house, thinking of ways of turning my garage into a crystal meth lab. You know, guy shit. All of a sudden, he gets up off my bed, rappels down the phone cord to the floor, and goes, "Hey, man, I gotta get going, I'm late." Then he starts running and running. Have you ever seen a midget in a hurry? Well, you'd know if you had, because they don't slowly get smaller like you and me. They just disappear right away. And then there's a beautiful rainbow. He was late for work. For work. If I was a midget man, I'd be constantly late. I'd come in hours late. My boss would be all pissed off. Where were you? Why were you late? I'm trying to run a chocolate factory around here. What's going on? Attell! I'd be like, why was I late? Look at these little legs! There was a puddle. I had to swim it, fucker.
The show that changed the entire Toledo radio landscape, and they haven't forgiven us for it since.
Eat your hearts out, you sappy bastards.
It's Randomosity.
Now put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Toledo's only vinyl radio show.
So talking about Judas Priest, you know, throughout the years, they were nominated for a number of awards, believe it or not, but it didn't take place, at least from what I understand, until 1991. They were finally nominated Best Metal Performance for Painkiller. They were nominated again in 1999 for Bullet Train for Best Metal Performance. Also, Best Hard Rock Performance for a song called Visions in 2009. And Nostradamus for Best Metal Performance in 2009. But they didn't win until 2010 for Dissident Aggressor for Best Metal Performance. Here's a fun fact about that song. That particular track, they had done 31 years, 32 years prior to winning an award for it. Yeah, fun fact. Good times at the Grammys, wouldn't you agree? All right, back into the program now. Judas Priest live at the US Festival 1983. Owens Community College Radio is the station. The show is Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show, the award-winning. And we're profiling the devil's music this month. Turn it up, people. Yeah.
How about the living after midnight?
Yeah!
All right, this is one big metal party, huh? But you're all invited back to my room after the show for a drink at the hotel, all right? Bobby McFarlane, you wanted to squeeze a few of you in this thing. Gonna try out something. Oh, yes, this is gonna be fun. This is gonna be fun. Some of you who saw us last year will know what I'm gonna do now, but if not, it's your first time for... It's the first time for everything. Oh, yeah! Oh!
America!
the Devil's Music, all October long on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show.
We'll be right back.
Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show, is a production of Randomosity Podcast, LLC, copyright 2024-2025. No portion of this program may be rebroadcast, retransmitted, or reproduced without the express written consent of Randomosity Podcast, LLC, and this station. You may be asking yourself, what station is this? It's Owens Community College Radio. You can download our app, Google Play, and the Apple Store. We've also got a QR code out there. Check us out on the website, owensoutcom.com. Owens, OUTCOMM.com. It's so big, we had to have two M's. Because, you know, we're different and stuff. We're the cool kids on campus. We rock it out, folks, each and every single week here on the program. Profiling the Devil's Music this month on the award-winning Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show. Week one, we did Kiss. Week two, we did Judas Priest. Next week, well, we're doing Satan himself, I think. The godfather of shock rock. Oh my God. We're going to hell for listening to this guy and for watching his concerts. Ooh. It's Alice Cooper. We're going to profile him. We're going to talk a little bit about his career, his shows, what brought him to prominence. Also, we're going to talk a little bit about what he's doing now regarding being the Antichrist. You're going to find it rather fascinating if you don't already know about this. All right? So check into the program next week right here on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show. Find us on social media, facebook.com/randomositypodcast. And X Randomosity TOL. My name is Dr. J. Thomas, and ladies and gentlemen, the doctor has left the office.
Devil's Music. All October long on Randomosity, Toledo's only vinyl radio show.